I love it. Canterbury Park is a fun place to be with the whole family when their horses are racing, but they have so much going on down there, so we want to just take a moment this morning to talk about how when the horses stop running, there are just fabulous programs to help so many people, and there's so much going on there. So we have two guests, actually three guests, to introduce you to this morning. We have Mark Irving, who is a former jockey and an ambassador at the Canterbury, which we had a chance to spend some time with you a couple of weeks ago. And we have Sally Mixon right here. Hi, Sally. And we have gorgeous Boxer. Oh, mm-hmm. My goodness. Thank you both for bringing Boxer.
Absolutely.
Okay, let's start with you.
Okay.
Let's talk about what's happening this weekend.
Okay, today is the Minnesota Derby and the Minnesota Oaks. The Derby's for three-year-old boys and the Oaks is three-year-old girls. So I actually won the Minnesota Derby on a horse called Croc Croc. For one of the owners at Canterbury Park, Dale Shenian.
Wow.
So I'm very excited to be here on Derby Day. That's why I'm dressed in the...
Well, you look great.
Seersucker suit.
So only Minnesota horses in the Minnesota race today, is that
correct?
True?
Correct, and okay. The girls too.
And what time is the first race?
The first race will be about 5:10.
5:10.
Yes, it's evening racing.
So Bobby came out with his family on the 4th of July. Met him on the 4th of July and you took him on this great tour. And then a couple of weeks ago, we all had a chance to come out. Justine, our producer, and her husband Brian, my family, and Bobby and Phyllis. And we had such a great time going in the paddocks, going in the winner's circle. And this is called a VIP tour. And tell us a little bit about how you can do that.
Okay, being a former jockey from the UK and a former jockey from Canterbury Park, I talked to Randy Sampson, the CEO, and thank you, Randy Sampson, for giving me the opportunity to do this. But I give them the ownership experience, and we go into areas closed off to the general public, and I give them a synopsis of what's going on. I talk about
you
my
take
career.
A lot of pictures.
Yeah, take a lot of pictures, talk about my career as a jockey, and try to give people an idea and want to look at a horse prior to the jockey's mounting. So it's very much a VIP experience. Then we go to the winning circle and watch that race from the winning circle. So they just love it. It's
so
amazing.
Much fun. My mom and dad were there,
yep.
And my husband and my son, and again, Bobby and Phyllis. So that's my mom and dad. We had a great time. So thank you so much. So that's something you can sign up for and do at Canterbury.
Absolutely, online.
Which is a great idea. Now, let's get to this. Boxer, tell me about Boxer and what Boxer does for so many people.
Yeah, so Boxer retired last year. From racing, and now he works on the backside. We've partnered with Canterbury Park, and he works with military and first responders, as well as stable workers, struggling with PTSD, trauma, addiction, depression. So he has an entirely new career saving lives.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah.
So that's something that a number of retired horses will probably have a chance to do because you guys set this up, right?
Yeah, so through Abijah's on the backside, we have two right now, off-track thoroughbreds that work 5 days a week, saving lives. And then our hope is to get more and more involved as we grow and expand.
Well, we know that animals, of course, love, or people love being around animals, but it actually
does. And they love mints.
And it actually does help them. I mean, it helps them, right?
Yes.
I'm a client.
Yeah.
I'm a client. I just came out on social media with my mental struggles because I'm on my 9th concussion. So these guys saved my life, too. And that's why I'm all in with Abijah. I'm all in. Any way I can help.
So Abijah is the name of the organization.
Correct.
And Boxer. And then, of course, you can come meet Sally, too,
yeah.
Which is great because this is all, you know, you get to learn about the horses, but the horses will help these people.
It's amazing.
And we couldn't do it without Canterbury Park.
Absolutely.
I mean, they've been incredible. Because of them, we're able to help save lives.
Isn't that fabulous?
Yeah.
Because that whole backside is filled with all those gorgeous horses.
Yeah.
And then when they're retired, they get this second life. And then you're
pretty
able
cool.
to help other people further their lives and make it better. Well, Mark and Sally, thank you. And
thank
Boxer.
You.
Thank you so much.
Eat your flowers.
Gorgeous. I don't care. It's okay
no
if he
flowers.
Eats my flowers.
Can I say one more thing about the Derby, Belinda?
Yes, you can.
This is a pretty special race, not only because I won the Derby, but my good friend Bob Lothenbeck, that you met in the paddock, actually, he has one of the betting favorites in the race.
Yes. Tonight.
Yep, yep.
And that's so exciting.
So it's going to be amazing. And Bob actually is excited about Abijah, too. I think Bob's going to be a part of this, too.
Well, we have all the information on care11.com. So people can find out how to get the VIP tours,
absolutely.
How to come out and enjoy Canterbury with their kids, and also how to help this great charity. Thank you so
Thank
much.
You.
Thank you to Boxer. Thank you to Mark.
You're welcome,
we do
darling.
Appreciate it. And we'll be right back with more Care 11 News.